Welcome to ECG first class. What is ECG or what is electrocardiogram? Electrocardiogram means electrical activity of myocardium or cardiac muscles, which is presented by a graph, is called electrocardiogram. When an electrode is directly placed on myocardium, the electrical activity of the cardiac muscle presented by this graph. This is depolarization caused by the sodium entry, and this is repolarization caused by the calcium ion entry and potassium exit. But when an electrode is directly placed on chest wall, the electrical activity of the cardiac muscle presented by this graph. This is QRS complex, which represents the depolarizations, and this is ST segments and T-wave, which represents the repolarizations. Now, the basic concepts of formations of the waves in ECG. When an impulse passes towards an electrode, this electrode shows a positive wave. But when an impulse passes away from this electrode, this electrode shows a negative wave. And when an impulse passes at a right angle to this electrode shows biphasic wave or a small positive wave. There are 12 leads. 6 leads are chest leads. These are the unipolar leads, that is V1 to V6. And another 6 leads are limb leads, lead AVL, lead 1, lead 2, lead 3, lead AVF and AVR. These are the bipolar lead. These 2 leads, 1 and AVL, indicate superior lateral surface. High lateral surface or superior lateral surface. 1 and AVL indicates superior lateral surface. And these 3 leads, lead 2, 3, AVF, indicates the inferior surface of the heart. And V1 to V6 leads are anterior to the heart, so these leads indicates anterior surface of the heart. V1 to V4, they are more close to the septum, so these are called anterior septal. And V5 and 6 are located on most laterally, so these are called anterior lateral. When any abnormality is found in V1 to V6, it is indicates anterior surface. When any abnormality is found in V1 to V4, it indicates anterior septal. And when any abnormality is found in V5 or 6, it indicates anterior lateral. But when any abnormality is found in V1 to V6 with 1 and AVL, it indicates extensive anterior. AVR usually indicates right atrial cavity. Now, I am going to discuss on a normal ECG paper. These are the large square, these are the large square, and these are the small square. A large square contains 25 small squares. Right to left direction indicates duration. One small square duration is 0.04 second. So, 5 small square, that is one large square duration, is 0.04 into 5 is equal to 0.2 second. Above downwards direction indicates height or depth. So, one small square height is 1 millimeter. So, 5 small square, that is one large square's height, is 5 millimeter. Now, I am going to discuss on normal ECG formations and physiological or normal electrical activity of cardiac muscles. When an impulse passes from the SA node to AV node, the atrial activation occurs. This is number one impulse. And when an impulse passes from the left bundles to right bundles branch, the septal activation occurs. This is number two impulse. And when an impulse passes from the endocardium to pericardium on the both ventricles through the Purkinje fiber, the ventricular activation occurs. And two ventricular activations, usually left ventricular activation is predominant because the left ventricle is more thick than the right ventricle. So ventricular activations vector usually oriented to the left sides. This is number three impulse. Number one impulse is oriented to the left sides, number two impulse is oriented to the right sides, and number three impulse is oriented to the left side. Chest lead V1 is placed or located on the right sides. In chest lead V1, this impulse passes at a right angle to the chest lead V1. So, number one impulse produces a biphasic wave, that is P wave. Impulse number two passes from to the right side, that is towards the electrode. So, number two impulse produces number two wave, that is R wave, which is positive wave. And number three impulse is oriented to the left sides, that is number three impulse is away from this chest lead V1. So a negative wave is formed. So number three impulse produces three waves. It is a S wave. And T wave always follows the R wave. In case of the chest lead V5 or 6, number one impulse passes towards this lead. So a positive wave is formed. That is number one impulse produce number one wave, that is P wave. Number two impulse passes away from this lead. So number two impulse produce negative wave. These two impulse produce this two wave, that is Q wave. Number three impulse passes towards this lead, B5 or 6. So these three impulse produce a positive wave. So three impulse produce three wave, that is R wave. And T wave always follows the R wave. In this way, from V1 to V6, gradually R wave increases and S wave decreases. This is normal phenomenon. And this is the basic concept of normal ECG formations. Now I am telling about normal ECG waves, segments and intervals. This figure shows normal ECG waves, intervals and segments. This is isoelectric line or baseline. And this positive wave is P wave. It indicates atrial depolarizations. This negative wave is Q wave, this positive wave is R wave, this negative wave is S wave, and this positive wave is T wave. From the onset of the Q wave and end of the S wave is called QRS complex. It indicates the ventricular depolarizations. From the onset of the P wave to the onset of the QRS complex, that is Q wave, this is PR interval. It indicates atrioventricular delay. It is prolonged in first degree AV block. From the end of the QRS complex to the onset of the T wave, this is ST segment. It is in isoelectric line. It may be elevated, may be depressed. When it is elevated or depressed, it indicates ischemia. From the onset of the QRS complex or Q to the end of the T wave, this interval is QT interval. It indicates the ventricular depolarization plus repolarizations. Now I am going to discuss on axis, cardiac axis. This is normal axis. this axis or this vector is oriented to the left sides and downwards. In this case, the lead 1 shows positive QRS complex and lead 3 shows positive QRS complex. So when an ECG shows lead 1 shows positive QRS complex and lead 3 shows positive QRS complex, it indicates normal axis. But in this case, that is left axis deviations, here axis is deviated to the left sides, this impulse passes to the lead 1, so this QRS complex is more prominent and R wave is more tall, but lead 3 shows negative QRS complex because this impulse passes away from this lead. So when an ECG shows lead 1 shows positive QRS complex but lead 3 shows negative QRS complex, it indicates left axis deviations. It is usually found in left ventricular hypertrophy or left anterior hemiplegic, or it may be normal variant. Now right axis deviations. This vector is oriented to the right side. This impulse passes to the lead 3, so this lead shows positive QRS complex. This positive QRS complex is more prominent, this R is more tall. This impulse passes away from this lead 1, so this lead 1 shows negative QRS complex. For these reasons, when an ECG paper lead 1 shows negative QRS complex and lead 3 shows positive QRS complex, it indicates right axis deviations. It is usually found in right ventricular hypertrophy or left posterior hemiplegic, or it may be normal variant. Now I am going to discuss on normal ECG waves and segments. This is P wave. The height of the P wave, normal height of the P wave, this indicates height, is less than 2.5 small square, that is less than 2.5 millimeters. The durations of the P wave less than 3 small squares, that is less than 0.12 second. The Q wave, the depth of the Q wave is less than 2 small square, that is less than 2 millimeters. The durations of the Q wave, duration of the Q wave less than 1 small square, that is less than 0.04 second. The normal height of the R wave, normal height of the R wave less than 25 small square, that is less than 25 millimeter in B5 and 6 leads, and less than 13 small square, that is less than 13 millimeter in AVL lead. Gradually R wave progressions from V1 to V6, which is already I have mentioned. S wave, the depth of the S wave is less than 7 small square, that is less than 7 millimeter in V5 or 6 lead. Gradually regressions of the S from the V1 to V6, that is I have already mentioned it. The QRS complex, the onset of the Q and end of the S, these are called QRS complex. The durations of the QRS complex, the durations of the QRS complex is less than 2.5 small square, that is less than 0.10 second. In lead V1, R is greater than the S, sorry, R is less than the S, and V5 and 6, R is greater than S. The T wave, the height of the T wave is less than 5 small square, that is less than 5 millimeter in limb lead, and less than 10 small square, that is less than 10 millimeter in chest lead. Now I will discuss on PR interval and ST segment. The durations of the PR interval
that is from onset of the P to the onset of the QRS complex is called pair interval. The durations of the pair interval is less than 3 to 5 small square, that is less than 0.1 to 0.2 second. ST segment is in isoelectric line. It may be elevated, may be depressed. The height or depth of the ST segments usually less than 1 small square, that is 1 millimeter in limblets, and less than 2 small square or less than 2 millimeters in the chest leads.